She may have saved his life. A young woman runs to the aid of a stranger who is brutally beaten, then shot twice.
It happened last night at the 1600 block of Earl Avenue. Gary Parker joins us now live at Metro Police headquarters with her story in this WLKY exclusive. Gary?
Rick, Vicky, that victim is alive today, much thanks to the heroic efforts of this neighbor, who was also a nursing student. Mariah Walker saw the violent crime unfold right from her house. Police say suspects in a dark car and a red Dodge Magnum were shooting at each other. Neighbors say the driver of the dark car eventually ran the red Dodge off the road and into a front yard. Everyone in the red car ran away except for one man, a black man in his 30s, who was pulled from the car, beaten, and then shot twice in the chest. Walker, a nursing student, did not know the man, but immediately rushed to his aid.
He had two gunshot wounds. I had to apply pressure and talk to him because he was going in and out of consciousness. So I had to talk to him and let him know that he needs to stay up until the EMS got there to help him. I wasn't thinking. I just did it.
Walker added applying pressure was key to saving the victim's life.
Because when you apply pressure, it stops the bleeding. You stopping the bleeding from getting out, from him bleeding more.
Officers searched for the shooting suspects, but later arrested 27-year-old Robert Mason after he was found with 25 various counterfeit bills in his pockets. When police did a cavity search, they found 26 more fake bills. Mason told investigators he stashed the money after a dice game. He was with the victim in the car at the time of the chase and fled the scene. Emergency crews arrived and rushed the victim to University Hospital. He is expected to live.
It was a big relief. Because it's actually scary to see somebody down there on the ground bleeding. And that close to you, gunshot wound. So it was scary.
And the men in the dark car fled the scene immediately after the shooting. Neighbors say they saw at least three men beat the victim. Reporting live at Metro Police headquarters, I'm Gary Parker, WLKY News.